In this screencast, I'm going to describe the van der Waals equation state, which is a better model for real gases than the ideal gas approximation, but it's certainly not the best model, but it allows us to see what the behavior is. So the van der Waals equation state relates pressure, absolute temperature, R is the gas constant, and V is the molar volume. So this is volume per mole. A is a constant, indicated here, and B is also a constant, and they're related to the critical temperature and the critical pressure, which is unique for each gas. So if we notice this term on the right side of the equation, since A is positive and V is positive, this overall term is negative, and this is due to the attractive forces. So this is how we're accounting for the attractive forces in a real gas that we ignore in an ideal gas. And what this says is that the pressure at a given temperature and a given volume is going to be lower than what we would calculate from the ideal gas. The constant B here is accounting for the repulsive forces as molecules get closer together. So this term in the denominator then says that the pressure, because repulsive forces, is going to be higher than what we calculate from the ideal gas equation of state. The van der Waals equation state is a cubic equation state. So when we look at the reduced pressure plotted versus the reduced volume, we'll notice that for a number of conditions, for example, at a reduced pressure of 0.4, there are three solutions to the cubic equation state. One of those solutions is going to correspond to the actual physical situation, or if we happen to be at saturation conditions, then two of the solutions will correspond to the physical condition. The middle solution does not correspond to a physical situation. This interactive van der Waals calculation is available online and was calculated using Mathematica. So what I'm showing here in this plot is the critical isotherm, where the reduced temperature is 1. If we lower the reduced temperature, then you can see below the critical point, we start having 3 solutions. And if we draw the point where the area above and below the curve is equal, then we've identified for that particular temperature the saturation conditions. And so that means for this isotherm, we're in the region above this horizontal line. We're in the liquid phase, and at lower pressures at this temperature, we're in the vapor phase, and we have 2 phases present where this line, and of course the line changes as we lower the reduced temperature. The other extreme, if we raise the temperature above the critical temperature, then we only have 1 solution at a given pressure. So the van der Waals equation of state, given just the critical pressure and the critical temperature for a gas, allows us to calculate more accurate physical properties for that particular gas.